So as we said, an average rate is not constant over the life of a reaction. So instead, what we look at is the instantaneous rate. What is the rate at this exact moment? Not over a period of time, but at this exact moment. And so let's think about that in terms of a plot. So we'll have the concentration of x over here, and then some change in time over here. And then we said that these functions are kind of exponential, so it'll decrease something like this. So one thing we'll look at is an instantaneous rate, right? So if we're thinking about what is the rate at this one moment in time, well, if you think to kind of calculus and math, when you're trying to calculate an instantaneous rate, what you're thinking about is the derivative, right? So you can draw a line through going through this point, and that'll be your instantaneous rate. Right, that'll be that rate at that exact time. And then more importantly, later on, what we'll focus on is the initial rate, right? What is the rate of the reaction when it just starts, when it is first starting? And that's the same thing that this picture shows. I don't like it as much as my drawing because it's a little more, has a lot more stuff in it, so it looks a little bit more convoluted. But go ahead, just pause the video. And then think about what this is telling you, right? It's taking slopes. So you're thinking kind of what's the instantaneous rate. And so the cool thing about instantaneous rate is we can compare different instantaneous rates just using a chemical reaction. So we can compare instantaneous rates using a balanced chemical reaction. So let's think about how we're going to do that. So if we have AA plus BB going to CC plus DD, right? So the A, the little a is some kind of number. That's the coefficient, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then the big letter is the compound, oxygen, nitrogen, ammonia, whatever, right? So that's kind of how the format goes here. And so we can say that the rate of this equation is going to be equal to the negative of some part of A because it's a reactant. And so what we do with this coefficient is you flip it. So the rate is going to be equal to 1 over A of A. Think back to the HI example. We had two HI forms and we flipped it, right? 1/2. And so this is also then going to be equal to the negative, since it's a reactant, of 1 over B times B, and equal to 1 over, oops, this should be a big C, 1 over C times C, and then 1 over D times D. So we'll take a look at an example next and see how this kind of makes sense.